Welcome back to the Surge 2 full walkthrough, covering all DLC items and alternative raw skills. And we are picking up right where we left off last time. Still running the same set, Killer Claw and the MG Cerberus set, all at MK9. Got the same implants as before too, not switching anything out quite yet. Pretty soon we will though. We're getting there. Could slot in something with 5 core power now. And we're going to head in this episode. We'll go into the Cathedral of the Spark, clear off all of the corrupted structures in there, go through to the underground, clear them out in there, get the last couple in CIT, and then there are none in downtown Jericho or anything like that, so the next area would be AID Command. And then we are going to proceed on towards the Great Wall, and then I'll end the episode there. We'll have one boss fight, Goddess Helena. And after we beat her and go get the rest of her set from the vendor, then we'll stop at the Great Wall.
Soon I will bring about a new age of harmony between man and machine. A new era. A new dawn. Such a shame about dear Jonathan. But sometimes one just has to be pragmatic. No matter how much it hurts, I have big things to accomplish, and I can't afford anyone to leave anything that may tie me to little Johnny's unfortunate demise. I'm sorry for what he became. Sorry for the shame he brought upon us. Sometimes I even feel sorry for using a pawn to get him out of the way.
Class act, that, Brother Eli.
My favorite regular. How can I help you today? Thank you again.
And once again, to show you, nothing here that we don't already have. Let us proceed on to the cathedral. If you wanted to gear up a bit more and level up a little more, then you could always go ahead and head. This is a kind of a good point to head back over to Kraken and sort of show Proto some good moves. But we're just going to continue on with what we have because we're already overpowered compared to where I was at in my first playthrough. So I have no doubt we are well equipped to take on the rest of this. So you can use the medbay if you want. Otherwise, we're just going to take this exoline here, which will take us out to the Cathedral of the Spark. And there's probably going to be a little bit of backtracking and overlap as we go through the cathedral. I don't remember exactly where every single corrupted structure is, so bear with me. I will try and do it as efficiently as I can. I think the way I'll do this is to go via the medbay. We'll use that as our starting point, and we'll at least save ourselves there so that we can continue on. If we do die, we'll just go back to that point. Okay, now. I know there's one outside, so we'll go and grab that one first.
Johnny.
right down the steps here. Charge attack. Break the barrier. Now, this has some nanite slurry on the ground, so you just want to jump out, get that quick jump back. Get three of those guys, you probably want to back out and separate. And the biggest annoyance is that guy, so I'm going to just take out him really quick. Ah, they fell down. So that's one way to deal with them. And we've got the other corrupted structure here. Grab that one. And really, I mean, we could just run around looking for them. We don't need to fight all of these guys. So I might actually do that because I want to make this as quick as I can. So I believe that's all of them in this area. Area. We'll head out this way. That brings us back to the reactor chamber. Conveniently enough, there is another barrier right over there. And in order to get that one, we need to go to where little Johnny was. So to get that one, I'm going to go back up top. I wonder if this guy is going to follow me. And I'm just going to take... Actually, no, you know what I'm going to do? I'll show you the other pathway down to where little Johnny's head was. Whoops, didn't want to go down that. So you remember the shortcut that we opened up to get over to Rex in April and to do that quest? We can go ahead and use that. Drop down one more level, so little Johnny is basically right below that platform there. So you can just drop here. And then you need to jump across over to that side. Break the barrier. Could have come through this way too if you wanted, but that seems to be the easiest way to do it. So we're gonna head back up to the med bay. I'm trying to remember if anything is in that the oratorium. Don't think there are any nanite barriers in there, but let's check just to make sure. Johnny. this area has none. Back into reactor chamber. And I think that should be all of them. The only other area that could have one would be either up here outside, which I know it doesn't have. Wow, April is still there too. It's very bizarre. You're at Camp Gateway Bravo, April. What are you doing there? So much for no religion. None there, none there, none there. And then this brings you back down into the Hall of Prayers. So, and I don't remember there being one in the room with all of the computer terminals. So I think that's it. We're just going to head out now to the outside area and go to the main cathedral area. I think there's one over there, too. I can remember where it is. And then we'll proceed into the Now, it's not mandatory to get most of these. A lot of them are just tech scrap or whatnot. But I figured for completionist's sake, we would go ahead and grab all of these. That leads you back over to April. So we'll go up here. Actually, there might not... I don't think there are any in here, right? I think we can go straight to the floor. I'll do a quick run through, but I'm pretty sure there are none out here. Yep, none there. Did I say you could hit me? That's what you get for hitting me in the back, dude, when I'm just trying to walk through. Got my batteries charged back up. There is an anite barrier. Forgot about that one. There you go, cash of bits. Tech. I don't think there was one up here, but I'll just double check. Looks like all of my tags are gone now, too. I left a bunch of tags in here and they're all gone. I wonder why they disappear like that. So into the underground next. To a secret boss that most people forget. Now, for this part here, this is where the elevator was before, but if we drop down there, I think there's a chance that we will die. So we're going to drop this way instead. And you can just drop right down here too. And you won't actually die, but you'll take a bit of damage. No big deal. Then we're going to head into the underground, back through the inner sanctum. And face off the secret boss that will get you the achievement triplets. Feel free to go ahead and use the med bay here. Spend your scrap if you want to. And you'll note that there's a barrier over here. We'll come back around this way a little bit later after we work our way through the underground. Spit us back out here by the med bay. So we're not going to follow that path yet. Getting a little bit of graphical artifacts here, so I need to restart my game. So I will go back over to the med bay, and we'll start the episode there again. Alright, proceeding on from here. Take these guys out again. As before, you want to creep around the side of these guys rather than dealing with the nanite sludge. You remember there was a little bit of loot that we got out there, but you don't want to fall down. We're back up into if you want to, you can go into CIT and set your save point there. I'll just show you real quick. There is an anti on top of which you and your stunts. So before we fight the Delver Echo Beta, which does not even show up in the wiki guide for some reason, I'm going to come over and break this barrier. So this brings you to, and I'll show you fast, this brings you over to the other side of the CIT where there's the med bay. So you can use the med bay here, shorter path. There's a barrier here that you can destroy as well, so that brings you back through the main area of CIT. There's no other barriers in CIT that we can break other than that, because we already went in the last episode over and broke that barrier and got that chest. So that's all of CIT and Cathedral. park, so we just need to do underground yet and AID command. So you can come right back out here. This guy, and I'll show you with the slam attack, the slide attack. That is a good gap closer if you've got something at a distance. But it usually does tend to stun them if they're kind of big. So just coming out this way makes it a little easier to deal with those three. Then you can take out this one if you want. Here we are, boss fight. You had to come back in here to get the third Delver Echo Beta in order to get the achievement. So we'll do that now. It's basically the same as the first version. Try and get a leg if you can. If you want to, you can go ahead and do parries and direction blocks. But as you can see, we've got plenty of battery power and health, so we can kind of just spam this guy. And ignore the fight mechanics entirely. So even though he's a boss, maybe that's why he's not on the wiki, and they've ignored him as a boss. I have no idea. He doesn't really qualify. You got a barrier back over here after you kill him. Couldn't take that out before. This leads you into Gideon's Rock. And I'll show you fast where that takes you. Last boss kill that we just did there should have gotten you the triplets achievement. If you didn't, you're missing one of the other Delver Echoes, so you want to go back through the previous episode and see which one you're missing. Now, this is a reasonably okay spot to farm MK9 components and MK7 components. So this one here is MK7. The other one that you can see over there is also MK7. And the one right there, which you can't really see all that well, is MK9. So if you wanted to get MK9 components, this is another spot to do it. I tend to think not having to deal with three adds is probably... And this guy, he's a bit of a menace too. He constantly hits you. It's a little bit more difficult. Come on, give me the sever. If you wanted to farm, I think he's more difficult actually than the scientists. If you want to farm MK9 components and you don't like the scientists, you can come over here and farm this guy. There should be no loot in here. Just double check. Indeed, no loot. And when you come out the top here, you'll open up one final door that was unavailable to us previously. So this gives you a shortcut from Gideon's Rock all the way down into the underground. And it's this door here that was above kind of Matea Forest area. Horsehead Trail. So if you come down that mag lift that leads right back up to the med bay, then you're in this area. Right? So that's where, sort of over there, is where the Kyoko Hackers NPC is, up that bridge, or up that set of white stairs over there. So just another shortcut. And we'll go back into the underground. As far as I know, there are no corrupted structures in Gideon's Rock. Other than this, obviously, this one here that we broke to get through there. Be careful not to run off the edge there. As you come around the corner, this is where we just fought the final Delver Echo. Come over here, break this barrier. Up the Exo line. There's just a little bit of loot that we want to get. So this is the guy, DLC guy who drops. It's codename Elise, if I remember right. And there's really no barriers in this section. So this is where the professor was. So we're going to want to basically just go up top as quickly as we can, because there are no corrupted structures down here. Stuck, huh? Get out of there. And you knocked me back in. Alright, you're annoying. So we wanted to go through that door over there. So we actually wanted to go to the right from where we came down from the professor. So we go up these steps. Take us up this. You can see there is a memory over there, and there's the corrupted barrier that we weren't able to get before. Now, technically, we could have come this way after getting to the Great Wall, but I figure it's better to do all of this stuff right now while we still can. And that way, we can just focus on the Great Wall and have to come back out and do other stuff. But I'll show you. So these guys, I think they're just easier. They swing slower than that other one. But if you come back here, there is a shortcut that will open up from the Great Wall back into this area. So you could come through this way and then run all over the underground and open stuff up. But it's just easier to me to do it now.
Your sacrifice wasn't for nothing. You'll be weak at first, but they won't find you. I'll keep you out of harm's way. Rise! Your time has come. You have to wake up. Wake up!
And that gives us another Athena vision. And the mimetic edge. Good nano damage, one-handed weapon, sorted by damage. So the mimetic edge actually has reasonable base damage, sort of like the infected slash brand. It is a good bit behind the JAG-22 Aeterna, but I'm going to upgrade all of these. maybe before the end of the next episode and show you how things stack up when we get them up to tier 9, maybe. I believe we have one other corrupted structure in this area. So this is back over, heading towards the med bay up top. And it looks like that loot dropped over the edge. So first med bay is up that way. I'm not going to use it. I'm just going to continue on. Getting lazy with this build. No war in here. Could go out to downtown Jericho City, but shouldn't be any corrupted structures there from what I can remember. Just the ones that lead over into A&E Command, that's it. And that leads back into the detention center. And the third scientist here for more MK components if you wanted them. Oh, you need to get away from that ledge. There. So if we come down here, there is one more corrupted structure, which was right here, which is the one that we broke from the other side of the med bay. So that circles us all the way back around to the Cathedral of the Spark. Then you can go out there to the underground if you were to Port Nixon, if we wanted to go out to Port Nixon. Trying to think what would be the fastest way back to Seaside Court so we can go to AID Command. And I think actually that might be the fastest way to get back. Because we can just run by the med bay and then we're in Seaside Court. Or we could go through Gideon's Rock. Yeah, we'll just go this way. Go to Gideon's Rock, Cloud 9, and then take the fast travel over to Gateway Bravo. That works too. So when you come out here, though, you just need to hang a right, basically, after you get past the DLC enemy. Hop across the toxic stuff so you don't get the effect. Go up the mag lift. And then we are at the med bay area, so you can take a right here. And run right up to Seaside. My banner. So we're going to go over to the government district, which is Gateway Bravo. And there's still a couple of ways we could go here. I mean, we could go through the exit this way. See what these guys have to say.
Damn, why did I ever hook up with Kate? What if it's too late now?
So poor Bugface, divorced Kate. Forrester hooked up with her.
Damn it, I mean, I never even told Kate how much I loved her.
Crayburn was also having an affair. So you can go out there into AID command. That's shortest path. I'll show you the other couple of ways to do it. You can come out the main entrance here. Down this mag lift and go in the door that's right over there. And I think actually that's the way we're going to do it because we have already broken all of the other barriers. I think that's the way. Just go ahead, break this barrier here, and go inside, in the right direction, there we go. And that'll let you go into the AID command. So we either came this way or we would have dropped down from up there, but I just wanted to break that barrier for you.
Bring it on, bastard!
Alright, so we've got another Ronin squad guy here. We should have all of the stuff from him already. I'll just sever the right arm. Just for argument's sake. You see, we've got the tungsten alloy MK7 for doing that. There is a little bit of loot back here now. Not sure who put that crate there. But be sure to thank that guy if you haven't already, Zaderbomb. And then this brings you back to the medbay. So we could have come in as we went down that maglift. We could have turned around and come through here. So the maglift up to Gateway Bravo, but we can come this way too. Now, from the med bay here, this is going to be our rally point, but hopefully we won't have to come back here and see it again. The gate that used to block your pathway through over here so you couldn't get to it is now open, and I'm going to show you up this way as well. There is a barrier here, and that takes you out to Andy Family Care Center, but that pathway that we used to use, that's the shortcut, is now blocked off. So I'm going to fight through the normal way. This takes you right back down to where we fought the Ronin Squad guy. Grab that audio log that he dropped.
The Ronin Squad is on the
take out these guys.
We have nothing left to lose. We'll drag this traitor to hell, even if it costs us all our lives. Duty demands nothing less.
Proteus enemy. For the Proteus stuff, we already have a full set. Just showing you. So no need to farm these guys. But I got a lot of weapons upgrades. I'm just going to focus on red arms for the most part. Can come through the scanner gate here if we want to. Take this guy out really quick. Grab the loot back here. That loot there too. So those are the MG Cerberus enemies. I'm going to show you there is one more pathway that we can take, which is down here. And there's an audio log right there.
Emergency protocol initiated. Major General Ezra Shields has been assassinated by an unknown rig-equipped intruder. Your mission is to retaliate immediately. All engagement limits are suspended, and maximum sanctions are hereby authorized. The perpetrator won't be easy to find. Both rig and neural interface appear to be stolen. There are no traces of this person in our database. This individual was a real pro. Track down and eliminate the target. These orders supersede all other commands.
Bit of loot there in that corner. Maybe I should tag that. I don't think a lot of people are going to look around the corner here. Not sure if people notice it or not, but I'll tag it nonetheless. Maybe if they're running around, they'll spot that. Not an easy spot. Not an easy piece of loot to spot. If you do come in here, there should be nothing left for you. But if you did miss that chest, then that is a piece of the Nano Ward armor set. We got that in the AID command episode. Now, coming up here, you've got a scientist, and he's blocking the only pathway through, so all of the other shortcuts are gone again. Thank you.
sever.
There we go. Another MG Cerberus MK9 guy. Back out and lure those guys over here. Try and separate them a little bit. So you can lure these with your gun if you want. Your last pistol. All of these, at this point in time, should be easy for you to deal with, though. Except for these little guys. Little menaces. I'm gonna take him out. Now, you don't want to go too far here, because you do have a boss fight just up ahead. So you want to take these guys out a little bit further back here. So this is all nanite sludged over, so you can't get through here, but that will lead to the boss right over there, which will get us back into the Yingwei and onto the Great Wall. Before we do that, though, we're going to want to come over here, and you'll remember that this door was not accessible before. It's now accessible. Get the final Ronin audio log. If you were missing any of the armor set pieces for the Ronin set, then you can loot this and you'll get them. Because we have all of them, we're just going to get some crafting components. Now it's time to do the second boss of this episode, Goddess Elena. And for Goddess Elena, what we're going to want to do is just target and sever the right arm. She basically has the same moveset as the big statues in Gideon's Rock. So you should be familiar with the moveset. And just make sure you focus on doing R1, R2, R2 to the right arm and defeating her that way. You can also do the directional blocks if you want. Break the shield first. doing the beam, you can't hit the shield. Shield if she puts it out. And that gets you the Twin Lance of Corruption, bottom tier damage for MK9 Nanite Spears, but it's sort of in line with these guys, the Infected, Vecchini, and Nanobarb. So if you want a Nanite damage weapon, there you go. It is a spear. So it'll stack fast, and we get Goddess Helena's armplate. So you get two Omnicells whenever you top up a battery with this one, and it increases the damage of continuously channeled drone attacks. So for drone builds, this is your ultimate set. Stack that with some good implants, and you've got unlimited ammo. And why is that not triggering? Sure to grab the loot from the chest. Brother Eli just tore through here. That's where Goddess Helena used to sit. And we are now at the Great Wall. Now at the Great Wall, the last area of the game. Grab the audio log over here.
My mother taught me the truth when I was but a boy. We are all...
I understand now. I finally get it. Everything is different. And yet, here I am. Same me. New shape. New destiny.
Here, and I'll replay that audio log that we just missed.
My mother taught me the truth when I was but a boy. We are all trapped by fate, caught in a moment soon to be forgotten. We live our lives without purpose. Humanity has made itself redundant. We've handed our future to the very machines we created. With every day that passes, we lose a little more of our knowledge, our abilities, our sheer unbridled power. Nobody is remembered unless they make a difference. Nobody makes a difference unless they fight. I will not leave this world without achievement. If we become more than mere humans, eternity will greet us with open arms. This is not a binary choice between being human or machine. The answer is human and machine, together as one. It always has been.
So an epic battle between Athena and Eli up top, Rogue Process versus the good nanobites. Open up the med bay. And you're going to save your tech scrap, don't spend it yet. Actually, we should have plenty, but I'm going to hold on to it anyway. And I'm not going to end the episode here quite yet. I will plant a banner right here, so easy for people to find. Just a little present. We've got plenty of tech scrap now. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to run back through. We could open up some other shortcuts and take a different pathway through, but this area I want to kind of do it all in one episode. So I'm going to run back through AID command to Camp Gateway Bravo, and then we'll come back here and I'll leave you off at that med bay. The reason for us going back through here is because we want to buy Goddess Helena's armor set, which is now available back over at Camp Gateway Bravo. So I'm not going to actually mess with these guys. I'm going to try and avoid them as much as possible and just sprint. So it's pretty much a straight shot. You could go out there and go up. Instead, I'm going to go through the med bay area just to show you the paths over to Camp Gateway Bravo is still available. Less enemies to deal with this way. And also, that pathway is still open. That'll take you over to Cloud 9 if you want to. You can't get back up that way, though. So we'll go up Maglift here, and then just continue straight across. That's the Maglift down. So from AID, or from Gateway Bravo, we can head down that one and back into AID Command. But now, we can just drop down from up above since we've opened everything up. That's interesting. I've never noticed the glowy nanites there in the air.
Shit! What's going on here? Some kind of crazy wizard just went up the wall. I'm not making it up, okay? Trust me. I saw him.
I can feel it calling my name.
It's happened again. Utter carnage. Even worse than at Creo. Do me a favor, okay? Finish whatever you set out to do. I'll be rooting for you.
That giant creature on the wall.
Take care, okay?
I can feel it calling my name.
He just says the same thing.
Hello. I'm so... It feels... To get together with Dr. Sorensen, I can make a real difference at last. I will never forget what you've taught me, both of you.
Good job out there. Ever since I... Huh. Sure. Just don't forget to buy something, all right?
All right. So we already got the Centauri set, so now we can pick up Goddess Helena's. Got the arm already, and the chest. Now we can spend our...
Broken loose. That creature.
Might as well take the end of the day
minute.
Off.
We'll be free!
And these guys are over here, so if you wanted any more ammunition.
It's me. Looks like we both got out, like, and... Yeah. No matter what... Yeah, sure.
Could grab more ammunition for your drone if you needed any of those. And you can spend your tech scrap. There's nothing really else that you can buy other than ammunition. We will drop down from here and go straight into EAD Command and then run back up to the Great Wall, and that will take us to our last episode. And for the Great Wall, got all kinds of surprises for you. The Great Wall has got all kinds of verticality. So it's an interesting map. Lots of little nooks and crannies and cubby holes and a couple of shortcuts to open up. So that'll probably take us at least an hour, hour and a half, plus the boss fight. Now when we get back in here, you're just going to want to sprint through like we just did. No point fighting all of these guys again. Sure you got full stamina as you're coming to sprint through here. That's it. We'll end the episode here. Feel free to hit my banner if you want to. Thank you all for watching. I hope you enjoyed. And we will see you back for the next episode. The final, number 10, episode of the Surge 2 Full Walkthrough.